I like your skateboard.
Thank you.
So you skate around here?
Yeah, I skate at the skate park over there.
No kidding. So did you know about this street sign?
No.
Well, what does it say?
Frederick Douglass Sprague.
Yeah. Is this the first time you ever, like, really...
Yeah.
Yeah? Did you know it was here? No kidding. What do you think?
So, new thing to me, I haven't seen it. I pass by here a lot. I've never noticed that.
How do you like that? And you live in the neighborhood?
Yeah, I don't live here. Like, I come here a lot.
Oh, you come here because it's like a nice spot with the skateboard thing and the whole thing, right? But you walk by this all, and this is the first time you ever saw this, huh?
First time.
So what do you think about this? You ever heard of Frederick Douglass? You never heard of Frederick Douglass? Holy moly. Well, he was probably the greatest black abolitionist of the 1800s. See right here, this ramp, this used to be a street. And this was the shoreline of Manhattan. Everything from here out is landfill. Everything from here out is landfill. At first, you see, and there was docks here, boats, there was water here, and boats would pull right up to the docks. And then from here to West Street, that got filled in first, the West Side Highway. So that got filled in first, and then later, starting in the 1950s, 1960s, then they made the Battery Park City area. They did that with landfill. Cool.
Actually, scale out there too.
Yeah.
Battery Park.
Yeah.
So they kick us out.
So that was all water. This was the Hudson River right here. Right here, bang. That far out or what?
Yeah.
So he escaped from slavery. Frederick Douglass escaped from slavery in 1838. He was 20 years old. Yeah. Think about that. He said, man, this fucked up being a slave. I gotta get out of here. And it was like, it was very complicated, but he figured out how to escape. He was down, in Maryland. He had to take like four trains and three boats. Yeah, four trains and three boats. Yeah, because it was 1838. Even railroads were new in 1838. They were all like small, short lines, and there was no bridges across the Hudson River.
I've heard about him before, but I never really learned about him in class or anything.
That's heavy, right? Yeah, because he kept pushing Abraham Lincoln to do the Emancipation Proclamation. He was like a major voice. He was the owner and editor of a newspaper called the North Star.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
Which North Star, it's like North represented freedom, South represented slavery.
I pass by this all the time. I come here, but I've never seen that.
And this was, you see, he came to New York City because there was the abolitionist movement was strong in downtown Manhattan. And, slavery was legal in New Jersey until 1846. He escaped in 1838. So he went from slave soil on the other side of the river, came across on the boat, landed here, and this represented free soil. Hey, you enjoy yourself, okay?
You too. No.
First wave.